experiment.
Measurement of?
So this experiment is measurement of screw thread diameters using profile projector. So we are using optical principle of magnification to see the threaded specimen to find the various thread parameters. So the main thread parameters we are going to find here is the pitch, major dia, minor dia, and depth of the thread, including the thread angle. So these are the parameters we are going to find in the thread given. So you can see basically the optical projector or the profile projector is basically used to magnify the image of the thread specimen so that measurements can be made easily. So you can see the thread profile. Okay, so this is how you get the display. So that we'll be seeing it later. So you will be having the cross wires on the instrument. So when you move the cross wires with the help of the moving micrometers that is provided on the work table, so the cross wires will keep on moving. So when you measure the crust to crust distance, it is called the major diameter. So say the reading of the micrometer when it is touching the above crust is R1, when it is touching the below crust is R2. So then we get, by taking the difference, we get the major diameter of the thread. So similarly, to find the minor diameter, we are finding the root to root parameters. Say R3 is the reading here, R4 is the reading here. By taking the difference, we get the minor diameter. So the depth can be easily calculated by taking the difference between R1 and R3 reading. That gives me the depth. So now we have a circular scale to calculate the thread angle. So the cross wires can be made coincident with the thread flanks, and you can even calculate the thread angle on the circular scale provided on the optical projector. So now the important parameters, so these are the formulas. So this diagram and this formulas, we can relate them. So basically you have two scales here, so two micrometers, so which one can move it in horizontal, and so in x and y direction you can move the micrometer scales. So it is very important to know the least count of the micrometer that you are using. So to find the pitch, so before finding the least count, first we have to find the pitch of the micrometer. So pitch of the micrometer is found by the distance uncovered on the pitch scale by number of rotations given to the circular head. So you know that the micrometer has one pitch scale which is fixed and one circular scale which is rotating. So for one rotation, what is the value that is uncovered on the pitch scale? So that you will be noting here. So in our case, it is 0.5 mm. For every 360 degree revolution, 0.5 mm is uncovered on the pitch scale. So it is 0.5 divided by 1, or you can just write it as 1 by 2, nothing but 0.5 mm is the pitch value of the micrometer. So coming to least count is given by pitch divided by number of circular scale divisions. So you have the circular scale, so in our micrometer it is having 50 divisions. So pitch divided by number of circular scale divisions will give me the value of least count. So the micrometer is able to measure 0.01 mm, so that is the least count of the micrometer. So coming to angular scale, where the angular scale is used for measuring the angle of the thread. So the least count is given by value of 1 MSD divided by vernier scale. So it is something like the vernier scale. So value of 1 MSD is nothing but 1 degree in our case. Then value of VSD is 30 minutes. So it can measure, so 1 degree can be written as 16 minutes divided by 30 minutes, that is 2 minutes. So 2 minutes is the least count of the circular scale which is used to measure the angle here.
Yes, dear students, now the experiment will be demonstrated practically on the profile projector. Professor Mithun is explaining it. Watch it out carefully.
Okay, so this is my profile projector. So you have the screen here, okay, so where you have the magnified image of the thread specimen. So the work table, okay, is provided by two micrometers. So one in the x-axis and one in the y-axis. So with the help of these micrometers, you can move left to right or up and above. So you can see the cross wires here. So it is in the form of a plus mark here. So it is visible. So the first reading, so that is R1, which we have already seen, is when the cross wire touches the upper crust of the thread. So we take the reading R1 from the micrometer here, so which is provided in the y-axis. So now as I move the micrometer, the thread specimen will move up. So now R1 reading is initially taken. Now The next reading will be taken when we reach the other side's crust. So now the cross wire is touching the crust. So now I will take one more reading. Let me call it as R2. So when I take the difference between R1 and R2, I will be getting the major diameter of the thread. So now using this, so the same procedure, when you make the contact at the roots, okay, root to root, so you will get the minor diameter. So similarly, you can even find the pitch. So for finding the pitch, you will be using the horizontal scale. So you can see that the cross wire is exactly at the crust position now. So to the adjacent crust, if you are finding the distance between two adjacent crusts, that is called the pitch of the thread. So now I will make a reading here. So that is the x-axis micrometer. So initial reading is taken. So call it as R3 for example. So now I will be moving it to the next adjacent teeth profile such that it makes contact exactly at the center of the surface. Now I will be taking one more reading. Say it is R4. So the difference between R3 and R4 will give me the value of pitch. So now you have the circular scale here, so which comes into play now. So to find the thread angle, so you have to make sure that exactly your for setting the cross wire exactly touches the root of any one thread. Okay, so now I have set it at one thread root. So now you have to rotate the scale such that it touches the flank. So make sure that it touches the flank. So you rotate the cross wires until it touches the flank. So now take the circular scale reading here. So you have to take the circular scale reading here. So now it is approximately 57. So 57 point, you have to see the coinciding division here. It is vernier division. So you can just keep it approximately as 55 degree. So now in the other side, to touch the other flank, you have to rotate the circular scale. Okay. So now it is approximately 347 degree. So now by taking the difference, okay, so by taking the difference, you will be getting the thread angle. So the thread angle will be approximately equal to 60 degree. The value of pitch will approximately be equal to 1 mm. So based on the thread specimen you are using, the parameters will vary. Thank you.